But this happened in the ocean. And it was farther south. It's when I lived down around, I lived in Hope Sound, which is down close to Palm Beach. And the water's clear there. It's not like murky here. So you can see your feet, you can see everything. This is just a little short story here, this one. But one day I was teaching my grandkids to surf, and they were probably 5 or 6 years old. And my son-in-law, he was standing by a board, and my granddaughter was on that, and my grandson was on my board. He was just sitting on it there. And all of a sudden, my son-in-law goes, "Hey, what's that over there?" And I go, "Oh, it's just some seaweed down the bottom." He says, "No, it's not. It's coming this way." So all of a sudden, this manatee right here, about this way, sticks his head up and goes, "Yes, you know." My granddaughter starts screaming on top of her voice. This scared my grandson. Before I know it, here's the board. He's climbing on top of me. He's trying to get way up here. You know? The only thing I can think of to calm him down is, "They're vegetarians! They're vegetarians!" I'm kind of calming him down a little bit. But this is my real story is that about the same time, it was summer, and there were no little waves rolling in. Down there, when in the summer, because of the Bahamas in the way, it's totally flat. But the water's about 85, 87, real nice and warm. So we're standing around in about this deep of water, and about 20 yards over this way were some other people. There were 4 or 5 of us, and we could see commotion going on. The water was kind of going like this a little. We go, "What's going on?" And they go, "Manatees, you know." So we could see them there a little bit. So I said, "Okay, I'm just going to stand here and watch them go by." So I'm standing, and pretty soon this manatee's coming right like this at me, and I'm kind of going like this, you know, as he goes this way. But what we did then, this is really amazing, I think. We turned around, this deep of water, and we started walking with them, just like this. This is how fast they were moving. So I had my hand on them, and we were petting them. Two or three other people with us, my wife was there. We walked 30 minutes up the beach, and they turned around, and 30 minutes back. Wow. So we spent a whole hour with 6 or 7 of them, just walking, and it was just really awesome. And when I got back, and it was all over, I was thinking about heaven. And you know, we'll be able to do that in heaven. We'll have such a relationship with the animals like they were originally in the Garden of Eden. And I thought how amazing that is, that we could put our arms around a lion, we could roll in the grass with him. You know, wouldn't that be neat? So that's what's going to happen there. And that was my story pretty much, but I thought a whole hour I walked up the beach and back, this deep of water, and spent time with him. The other thing, too, is that as Christian, you know, we want to remember, by the way, manatees are considered endangered, you know what that means. There's not a whole lot left. And in Florida, probably less, just because we have so many boats, and they run over, and they hit them, and scar them. And so in other parts of the country, they're, you know, like in the Caribbean, maybe a little better. But there's boats there, too, and that's their biggest problems there. So, but let's always remember to be kind to animals, treat them nice, love them, and we'll see them in heaven. Anybody need to pray this morning? Okay.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for today, and thank you for the children's.